This was our mini retro computer at the end of the last video. We had completed both the backplane and the CPU board. What we're going to complete today is the memory board. As with the other two boards, it comes with a nicely laid out manifest of all the components involved in putting this memory kit together. And we have the board itself. This is a board we're going to be populating today. So let's get started. As always, we will start with the lowest profile components first. In this case, we have a resistor, four of these capacitors, and a single other capacitor put in. So we'll put those in first. You know, let's identify all the components first that we're going to have to put in. So here we have our four capacitors and the other single capacitor. So they're fairly easy to tell apart. So we should have no problems in putting these together. I'll just take all the other bits and slide them back into the bag. And we have our single resistor. So resistor R1 goes in at this point in the board. So we'll just snip the ends off this and we'll put this into place. And we can now look to fit our capacitors. We'll slot each of the capacitors in. Now we have one to fit here. One in here. As always, it's quite useful to have something to hold your board while you're soldering. Either a helping hand or a bib like this. It'll hold everything in place while you need to solder. And as always, it's good to do a visual inspection to make sure you haven't missed anything. Right, those connections look okay. We can just snip off the excess now. Right, that's our first set of components now on the board. These are our chips and the sockets into which they're going to go. So we will look to put these in place next. Once these are in place, we can then look to put the chips in. So we have three large sockets and one small socket. Just make sure we orientate these the right way. And that's the four sockets in place. Just flip this over and we'll do a little soldering to hold them in place. And then we'll put them into the bag. It's fine. Now we'll put this into the rack and we'll finish off the rest of the pins. As always, it's important to take your time when you're doing a soldering, as it saves so much time later not having to debug something. And again, a little visual inspection is always good. Because you're making so many solder joints, it's so easy to actually miss one or to have a dry solder joint. Now, we do have a couple of jumper plugs to put in place. And then, of course, our edge connector. So according to our manifest, we have one 2-pin header and two 3-pin headers to go in, and another single right angled one in P2. Right, which is this one at the top here. Right, so let's get those connectors and put them in place. So there's our right angled one. That one's to go in here. Okay, we might need a little bit of blue tack to hold this in place while we solder. Should be able to get these in quite happily. There we go. That's P2 right angled quite happily in place. So that can take its little jumper, which is fine. So now jumper 3. Is going to be another 2-pin. Which will go in here. And then we may manage to get that one in without the bow tack. Just put it in just in case. Hold it straight while we solder. Right, that went in quite nicely. Okay, so we've got two other 3-pins to go in place. These headers aside. We have one to go in here and one to go in here. So we'll do these one at a time. Right, and again, a little visual inspection doesn't do any harm. Just to make sure everything looks okay. So we have our sockets in place, we have our resistor, we have our capacitors in place, we have the headers for the jumpers. Now the remaining part we have to do is the right angle connector, which will connect this in with the backplane. Sure it's in and steady. Right, okay, so as before, we will solder the ends just to make sure it's in place before we put it into the assembly and we do the rest of the pins. So we can now put it into our rack and do the rest of the pins now. And that's just completed one row of pins. I'll now turn it around to allow us to do the second row. Again, a little bit of visual inspection to make sure we haven't made any mistakes. And when you're quite happy that all this has been completed, that should be the last of the soldering on this board. So we'll just take it back out of the unit and we can now look at putting in the jumpers and our IC sockets. So with a small chip is going to be an easy one, as there is only one of these. So just ensure its pins are angled in very slightly, so we can easily slot it in to this socket. Making sure that we have the orientation correct. And this one's a bit of a challenge. And that's the IC securely in its socket. Now we have the RAM to put in and the two ROMs. So let's just have a look at our chips and see which is which. These are the two ROMs, and this one at the bottom will be a RAM. And we'll just bend the pins in slightly as we did before. And I want to make sure we don't bend any of these pins. Should be us in place. And that's the chip securely into its socket. So just the two ROMs to go. Let's ensure we get these in the right way. A little more bending on this one. It's in place. And that's that ROM securely in socket. And our final chip. Just bend its legs. That's about us. And there we go, our final one in place. So there we have all the components on our board. Now we have right enable. So I think we'll put those in first to disable the write enable for the moment on our chips, so we don't want to write to them inadvertently. And I need to check the instructions regarding jumper 3, the flash ones select. So we shall have a look on their website to see what they say. But as far as building the board is concerned, it's now complete. So for the moment, we will slot this in onto our backplane as the next board. And this should slide in quite happily into place. Which it does. And there we have our completed Z180 computer. So that about wraps it up for this video. What we'll do in the next video is the final configuration of the jumpers, and we will try powering it up and see how it behaves. But that's it for today. Thank you for watching.